Hatchkins Dunlap. Mr. Joseph, how are you? It was regarding the invoice that we sent you last week. When may we expect payment on the tower project? When what freezes over? Mr. Joseph, you are so funny. All right, 2 weeks. Good. Okay, have a good day. Bye-bye. Ted said to tell you you're dynamite. No, it's okay. Let's see. He wants you to watch out for a possible light glare problem with those big windows. Oh, and the Zalon office has decided against the theater. They would like it to sort of come out of the presentation.
A small detail.
Kid, at this rate, it won't be long before that sign reads Hutchkins, Dunlap, and Cody Prescott.
Oh, assuming Cody Prescott survives.
I'll get you one.
I hear a heart pounding. Molly, make that 2 aspirin. Get it over with.
Get it over with? I wish. I can't even get it started.
Why don't you just ask her out?
I can't. I just don't understand the game.
Well, I'm the wrong person to ask for advice. Oh, Molly.
Miss Prescott? Miss Prescott. I think line 183 is in the right place.
Put it higher. No, that's awful. Oh. Sam, what do you think?
Well, actually,
you can do it.
You're as hot as a pistol. Come on, you're going home.
I can't. I've got too many structural problems to work out.
Come on. You go home. I'll take care of your structural problems.
Okay, well, you won't forget to send off those plans, the first revisions to Philadelphia this afternoon?
No, I won't.
Okay.
By the way, your ex called.
What did he want?
He told me to tell you that he hopes he never sees you again.
Well, his wish is granted. Oh, damn, I forgot the sale. Come on, plans. Oh. You know, I really miss that little theater, but I can't believe those guys.
Oh, and you also took his Music to Make Love By album, remember that?
It's mine, and it never worked in you.
Rest.
Cody? Cody?
She's sick as a dog. I sent her home.
Oh, no. I hope she didn't forget the Zalon project.
To replace it with a bowling alley. And I need the plans by 8 a.m., so take care of your cold and rest up. Bye.
Hi, it's me, Nick. Listen, did you take my blue and green pajamas? Look, if you don't want to talk to me, my machine will be on between 8 and 9 tonight. Okay, so I call and leave a message, okay? Bye.
Cody, darling, it's your mother here. Where have you been and why weren't you here on Sunday?
Thank you.
Mistake here. This is not your apartment. This is Kenny's apartment.
Kenny Gallant?
Yeah, you know Kenny?
I leased his apartment for him 3 months ago. What's so funny?
Nothing. Just relax. Look, Kenny's a friend of mine, okay? Whenever I'm in town, I stay here. I always stay here. Listen, he gave me a key. How do you think I got in here?
Well, I have a news flash for you. Kenny's in Switzerland.
Oh, yeah?
So you can just give me that key and move right back out. I live here now.
Now, how'd I know you're telling me the truth? Okay, oh, listen, okay, I got a proposition for you. Look at the time. It's very late. How about I stay just a night here, okay? Okay, I will stay here tonight, I'll stay right there, and then tomorrow I'll go, okay? Fair's fair. Bless you.
Oh, you're not gonna attack me?
Do you wanna catch that cold? I promise.
One night, that's it.
Okay.
Tomorrow you're gone.
I'm gone.
What's that?
Walter, stay. It's only Walter. Just...
Watch out! Excuse me.
Sorry. Just a second. I'm single or married?
Excuse me.
Okay. Nice legs.
So do you. I'll miss them. And your dog.
Thanks, Walter. Feeling a bit better today, are we?
Must be a 24-hour bug.
Do you want to know my name?
Sorry, not this morning. Got around.
Well, it's Vincent.
Vincent, I assume you'll be gone this evening when I get home?
That would be a logical assumption, I suppose.
It's been a slice.
How'd the revisions turn out?
Well, I think I figured out a way to bathe the lobby with clear-store light.
You're going to bounce it first?
Well, sure. I mean, it worked in the con building in Bryn Mawr. You know, I really do miss that little theater, though.
I don't know. Maybe I can get it back for you.
Yeah?
Yeah, I've got an interview with Mr. Zalin himself tomorrow.
Really?
Yeah. Anyway, these are good. If this thing goes, it is going to be so great for us.
Yeah, I know.
By the way, Cody, now that you and Nick have, you know,
split up?
Yeah, I thought, I'd like to take you to dinner. Maybe this weekend, if you're free.
Not dinner, Ted. Maybe coffee over the weekend.
Hey, that sounds good.
So look, I'll have these revisions for you in a couple of days.
Did you hear Frankenheimer got the Citibank contract?
Oh, you're kidding me. There's another landmark poor decision. So what's it worth?
6%, a couple of million bucks in fees.
Oh my God. That's him. That's the guy from last night.
You're kidding.
He's gorgeous.
What the hell is he doing on television?
God, what luck. Hey, I'm in
let's
shock.
Let's have Sam turn it out fast.
For Chef Henri for the next few months. What is the motivation for a truly great chef?
Well, I can't speak about great chefs. I just cook the food I like to eat.
I bet he does.
That's perfect. Vincent McBride, we look forward to your being our host.
Perfection.
Jan Gilford's for.
That's the hunk you sent packing. I don't believe you. Cody?
Supposed to be out of here tonight.
No, okay. Relax, all right? Just come on and sit down. And
Mr. McNeil.
Enjoy your meal. I hope you're hungry.
Mr. McBride.
Vincent. Yes, Ms. Prescott.
You can call me Cody. Oh,
thank you. It's a nice name, Cody. Now.
I saw your TV show today.
Oh, you did?
And I promised to watch it all the time.
Oh, thank you.
But I've got a lot of work to do tonight, and you've got to go apartment hunting. So, goodbye, and good luck.
I have a proposition I want to make to you.
I'm not really wild about propositions.
Well, just hear this one. It seems to me that, you could use a roommate.
What is that supposed to mean?
Well, someone to help out domestically, you know.
Is this some sort of comment on my housekeeping?
Listen. I'm only going to be in town for 3 months. It's the longest I ever stay anywhere. And I'm used to it here, and Walter's used to it here. It seems like I look for somewhere else. Plus, you know, I'm handy to have around. I cook.
Vincent, I live alone for a reason.
Oh, yeah?
Well, for several reasons, as a matter of fact.
Go ahead. Watching you.
You are?
I know.
But tell me about the TV show. You must be very excited.
Well, it's too early to be excited. I'm kind of superstitious. Nervous is better the word. You know, you have a beautiful mouth.
I do not. Listen, Vincent, you really can't continue to stay here.
Well, Miss Evan, it didn't work out.
What I meant.
What'd you mean?
Sit down, please.
What'd you mean?
Please sit down.
Okay.
I'll get dessert.
Oh.
First of all, congratulations.
On what?
On your TV show. Look, it caught me at a bad time. I just got over a very difficult relationship.
Nick.
I mean, he said it was all right if I had a career, as long as it didn't interfere with what he wanted.
This guy sounds impossible.
Yeah.
You can't afford to have a relationship with a guy like this. He's a jerk.
Yeah. I think a man can't deal with a woman who...
Are you serious about a serious commitment to her career and all that?
Yeah.
I don't know about that.
Don't interrupt me, please. I couldn't bear it if you thought for 1 minute there'd be any chance...
Sex, drugs, and rock and roll. Okay, yeah. I agree with that. Are you trying to beat these dishes or wash them? Listen, why don't you let me take over the washer and you dry and put it away. Come on, move.
Okay, okay.
Look at this. It's pathetic.
Now, if you get out of line just once...
What?
You're out.
Okay, I agree with that. Do you want to wash this first before we put it away, or... Great. Everything's great, man. Well, as far as Walter's concerned, don't worry about Walter. He's a good dog. He's like my family away from home. I need him here, but don't be afraid of him, okay? He won't hurt you. Don't be afraid.
A roommate and a dog. This is crazy.
You're not gonna regret this. I may, but...
That looks good.
Thank you.
Keep going.
Hey, Cody, let's go get a drink.
Too much work.
Oh, come on. Those revisions can wait till tomorrow.
I'll join you at Pedro's in a little while.
What a case. See you tomorrow.
Molly.
What?
I did something stupid.
What?
The cook?
Yeah.
I told him he could stay for 3 months.
What?
Don't what me? What's wrong?
Nothing. Nothing's wrong. Nothing is wrong.
Bye.
Okay, I can probably feel the groans right now out there because it's saying salmon. That's for rich people. Well, it's not. How much do we pay for this piece of fish? Yeah. You might think because salmon runs once a year, comes from one small corner. This is a gas-based salmon. Comes from a small corner of the globe. It's going to be prohibitive. No, $22. You buy roast beef and see how far $22 gets. And this fish will feed, what, 10 people?
That's Vincent McBride, the new chef on Cooking for Pleasure.
Well, course, the other thing is, I'm not going to stand here and tell you that filleting a fish is like a snap. You can pick it up in an afternoon. Well, you probably
can.
But you're going to need three or four fish before you really get used to it. You don't waste too much of the meat. This place is like, look at this fish. Is this beautiful or what? Oh, it's so tasty when you finally cook it. This is a salmon that wants to be cooked. This is a salmon that wants to be eaten. That's what we're going to do with it.
Can I take some of this for you?
Oh, no, it's okay.
Thank
no.
you.
Okay, well, good. Why don't you go upstairs and get changed, something comfortable, and,
Well, listen, I've got tons of work to do tonight.
You gotta eat.
Oh, that's true.
Good, well, everything's ready. Come on. Let's move it. Shiatsu?
No.
Should. Where does this come from? Did you acquire this or just Kenny's?
I don't know.
Just hate it?
Yeah. I guess so.
Dinner!
I'll get it.
No, I'll get it.
You're always talking, you know, you're making me talk about what I do. Why don't you tell me about yourself?
Oh, I work very hard. I got my degree in architecture 5 years ago, and then I went to work at Hutchkins and Dunlap. Ted Hutchkins is my boss. He was really very good to me. He let me work nights and go to school during the day so I could get my degree in engineering.
Must have killed your social life.
Yeah.
You know, you don't have to actually use the hashi. You can just use your fingers. It's just fast food in Japan, isn't it? What about? Oh. Should I make some kind of choice?
No, I think women have to make choices.
I think everybody has to make choices.
And I did.
Well, what kind of choices did you make?
Career. All the way.
Well, the expense of any kind of life?
Well, no, I love my work. It's my life.
Maybe you haven't been involved with the right kind of person.
What kind of person is that?
I wouldn't know.
What about you?
I could be.
Could be what?
The right kind of person.
That's not what I meant.
Is it?
No.
No? You're blushing. You are. I mean, how I got this show? Mm. Well, it's my old girlfriend is producing this show.
Yeah.
Well, it's Jan, the producer. That's my old girlfriend. She brought me up here from Milwaukee in an effort to goose up the ratings. Do you believe they actually say things like that? Goose up the ratings. You're going to love Jan. She's a trip. I'll bring her over here. You'll meet her.
Listen, every time I've got lots of work to do, and I've got to go upstairs and do it. I've got to design a bowling alley. Well, another 3 stars for a great meal. Your old girlfriend is really gonna get her money's worth.
Cody. Listen, I wanted to thank you again for allowing me and the dog to stay here. Walter's used to it, and well, I appreciate it.
I like the goddamn dog. Goddamn dog. God.
Good morning. Earth to Cody.
What's up?
Friday. Good morning. Good morning.
Terrible twosome.
He still hasn't asked you out?
Nope.
I'm looking forward to another...
Hi.
Another great weekend with the girls.
I give up on him.
I mean, men are so
They're so high. They're so unpredictable. They're impossible. They're naive.
Yeah. Yes, that's what they are, naive. Or does that stupid to describe them better? Hi, Sid, how you doing?
Molly, don't talk like that. I mean, that doesn't sound like you.
Hi, Sheila. Whose side are you on? Oh, the roommate.
No, he isn't even turned on by me. I mean, he kissed me last night.
Hi.
Hi, but like a roommate. I mean, maybe he doesn't even like women.
So he put the moves on?
You know, I mean, he...
Huh?
And when he stopped, I was disappointed. I'm furious with myself.
Hi, Sheila. You're sending out mixed messages, Cody. Why don't you just let it happen? I mean, just be casual.
Me casual? That's a joke. Let's do some work. I can see the bowling alley right now.
Okay. I don't see the bowling alley.
Well, I do.
That was awesome.
Did you find out what he had to say?
Well, I think we got him. The clincher was the clear story light.
Yeah?
Yeah, I can just see him sitting up there in his top floor office, gazing down at the empire below. It's too good for him, honest to God. So what are you guys up to this weekend?
Oh, the usual. Love and larceny.
Yeah.
Anyway, Cody, give me a call if you feel like it.
I gotta get a bagel. Our traditional Friday night movie?
Molly, I gotta skip the movie.
I think I get it.
No, you don't. It's...
Lady, do you want white seed or black?
White seed.
It's just that Vincent might make another special dinner and it would seem rude not to show up.
Listen to yourself.
I thought I'd buy another really good bottle of champagne to go with the dinner.
This is the girl who is staying away from relationships? Cody, do you realize that you have done another complete about face? Now you're buying this guy presents.
Oh, God, I am?
See you in the roof tomorrow. Maybe I'm sharp.
Right.
But it'll be interesting when we take the horns and everything off of it.
Oh, yeah. My mother always said, take the bull by the horns.
Oh, hi, Cody. How you doing? Oh, I want you to... Oh, you haven't met Jan. This is Jan. This is my producer and my friend Jan. And I want you to meet Cody Prescott. This is my roommate.
My nail polish was chipped. I hope you don't mind. I borrowed your nail polish.
We were just working on the show and...
Well, don't let me interrupt.
I guess I should go.
Yeah, probably. I'll walk you down. Okay. Sounds good. Jane's impossible, isn't she? Only she could make it look like we were actually...
Making out in the bathroom?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, no, we weren't making out in the bathroom. Never mind. But you must be hungry. Can I fix you something to eat now?
Oh, just for me?
Well, I ate with Jane.
Well, I ate at the office.
Then what's in the bag?
Shampoo!
Can I put that shampoo on ice for you? Night, Cody. See you in the morning. Yeah.
You and Jan weren't making out, were you?
I can't hear you.
You and Jan weren't making out in the bathroom, were you? Not that it's important, really, but you weren't, were you?
No.
You weren't?
No.
Oh, I see.
Why are we whispering?
I don't know. Good night.
Hey, Walter. Got a flash for you. She likes us.
So, where is he?
Search me.
Champagne dinner?
I blew it off.
Cody, what's up?
Let's concentrate. He's probably out with his dog.
Oh, I love it. A boy and his dog.
Hi, Vincent. This is Molly. Molly Vincent.
Hi. Nice to meet you. Why don't you get back to the line? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Stupid rules. I don't remember why I made them anyway.
You were disenchanted with men, remember?
Right. I do.
Bye, see ya.
Where's Molly?
Oh, she had to go. An appointment.
Having trouble?
Yeah.
Oh, I am just caught in here. There you go.
I want to go to the zoo.
Zoo? Yeah, we can always go to the zoo.
McBride, my new roommate.
Ed Hutchkins.
Hi. Oh, you're the boss.
Yeah. Can't offer you any pancakes.
Yeah, well, I'm sorry to barge in. I just thought you might want to go sailing. We haven't taken her out for a while.
Oh, it is a great day, Ted.
And, we need to talk about the little theater.
You're gonna listen to me. Mm. Thank God! Well, listen, if Vincent wants to go, I'd love to.
I can't. I got plans.
What plans?
The ones we just made.
We can do it some other time, okay? It's just that we haven't, it's just that we haven't talked for a while outside the pressures of the office. Your newfound interest in cooking?
Ted, please.
See you Monday.
Bright and early.
It's nice to meet you. This is your mentor?
Whatever you're thinking, forget it. It is possible for some people to have non-sexual working situations.
Is that right? I need my apron.
Why didn't you want to go sailing?
With Ted?
Well, if you want to get to know me, you have to...
Have to...
I was afraid of this.
I do want to get to know you better. Honestly.
Well, I have an idea. Let me take you out. Come on, let's go.
Dimensional system that multiplies in length and height, right?
Not in width?
Of course, width.
Very good, and?
Well, it's informal, but it's strong, you know?
Uh-huh.
I love the way it sits beautifully in this little hill with all the trees around it. How am I doing?
How do you feel about the architect who designed it?
Oh, I don't know.
You don't? It's my design.
Oh, I like this architect. I think Cody Prescott, she's a genius. It's so beautiful, too.
Tonight. Oh, no.
It's not like an idea. Look, Jan's coming by picking me up at the house. Why don't you come along, come to the station, get some beer for us. You want to?
You're not serious.
Why don't you, Cody? I know you feel the same way. What's the matter? What did I say? What's the matter? What?
I can't, we can't, and I don't believe you.
Hold it, just hold it. What's the problem?
I mean, really. You don't want to know Ted, but I'm supposed to be thrilled to spend Saturday night with Jan.
It's nothing to do with Ted and nothing to do with Jan.
No.
What are you getting so excited about?
I don't know.
It's a thing all totally in the past.
Yeah.
Completely blown out of proportion.
I'm acting like a schoolgirl. He's a total flirt. And that Jan, she's something else. I've got to get my head back on straight.
You've got to be nice to your boss. It's just office politics. Stop reading something into it.
I've watched them. I mean, he can't control himself. He tried to seduce a fly.
So?
What do you mean, so?
Oh, Sam called. We're having brunch tomorrow.
Oh, you're kidding.
I'm serious.
If we were all so emancipated, then why are we playing games all the time?
Are you talking to me or you? I'm gonna seduce Sam. We'd make great kids.
One kiss. The adrenals go crazy, and we want to have his kids and fold jockey shorts for the rest of our lives.
Yeah, but I haven't felt this way in years.
Vincent's playing with my feelings.
There's one way to find out what those feelings really mean.
I don't know if I could handle a career and a man. I don't know if I even want to right now.
Who is talking about relationships? I am talking about sex. Sex! One hot dog with the works, please.
I'm gonna cook him dinner.
Oh, now that's a big move there, Cody. Yeah, that would even scare me. Very brave. Very sexy.
Thanks for coming out. I feel so much better.
Seduce him.
Okay? Who could resist my chicken with carrot stuffing?
Hey, how's it going? This is Vincent McBride. Welcome to Cooking for Pleasure. Well, guess what's for
and
dinner tonight?
I'm going this to cook for you meals. My chicken with carrot
nice,
stuffing.
Tomato and garlic sauce. You're going to love this. As you can see, I've got the onions here. We're sweating the onions. It's a cooking term for it. You don't want them brown. You want them nice and shiny. Okay? And now we get to the sexy part of the meal. My favorite. Tomatoes. Now, why is it they always compare a tomato to a nice-looking woman? I don't know. See, I don't see the point in running out and buying yourself some store-bought tomato sauce. There's no point when you can spend time with creatures like this. I mean, every time I deal with tomato, I'm trying to lose it. See, it's so simple, too. You just take this tomato, get the skin off, and it goes away so soon. Look at that. Well, this reminds me of my first trip to Venice. My first trip to Europe, I went to Venice. Fault the equipment in here. See, you too can do this at home. You pay $2,000, get yourself a nice machine like this. No problem. But when I went to Venice the first time, I met this great girl. What was her name? Angelina, that's it. I'm telling you, dark, raven hair, beautiful. She took me to this little restaurant just behind the Grand Canal. So the dish is quite similar to this, except they had some jalapenos and cayenne pepper in it. They called her angry pasta. It got me really fired up. She went for a little walk around the canal afterwards, and she stopped, and she said to me, that's another time, okay? You don't want to hear about this. See, now, that's exactly why you want to prepare your food in the kitchen and present it. There's no point fussing that special guest, is there? Looks good? Let's go. Yeah, doesn't that look good? Along with your fettuccine, I might suggest you serve a nice French crusty roll. Perhaps a nice bottle of red Valpolicella. And someone exquisite to watch eat. So this is Vincent McBride, hoping that you find some of the pleasures in cooking that I have, and I'll see you Monday, all right?
I
don't want to play.
Oh, we just stand there and I'll play.
Look, Jan, I enjoy working with you. I like doing the show. And if that's not... If you're still interested, just call me, okay?
Thanks for the ride.
Thank you.
I got home as fast as I could. I was worried you wouldn't be here. Jan's my sexy boss.
She's this beautiful, articulate, successful woman with this great figure and nice...
What's that?
This is your ideal man. I brought this for you from work. See, they won't
go on the carpet. I've never even given that a thought.
All right.
I've never thought about it once.
If you don't give me the truth,
I'm
gonna tickle you.
No!
I want the truth.
Okay, what's...
I want those long ones.
It wasn't supposed to happen this way.
How was it supposed to happen?
You know, I was through with men, with all their hang-ups and all their demands. I can't believe I just said that.
Cody?
I love you, Cody. I don't want to place any demands on you. But why can't we just be two separate people living our own lives? It's possible, isn't it?
Yeah. You mean I don't have to cook for you?
Right, the way you cook.
I can be messy if I want to be.
Step in the kitchen. I want to change you. It's the last thing I want. You know how that old song goes? You have no idea.
What?
I love you just the way you are.
Salon people called this morning, and are you ready for this? You're not ready for this, man. Even the little theater is back.
Ted, that is fantastic!
Of course. I mean, it's really important to the whole concept of the project. You know, I can't believe I made it through all those meetings. Political handholding is not my strong suit.
As usual, you were perfect. Sit down, we gotta talk.
This sounds serious?
Yeah. This project is brilliant. It's massive. It's been yours from the start. And I need you to move to Philadelphia to cover it.
Move there?
Fast tracking is the only way we're gonna get this thing done. The Zalon people want it, and I'm not gonna get a bit of sleep for the next year and let you go down there.
Ted, I don't know.
I understand about Vincent. I'm sorry. I did not count on you falling in love.
Neither did I. Look, he supports my work totally. You can have me 24 hours a day, no problem. But Philadelphia.
It's your project. I need you there.
Hey, Walter. How you doing? I got some good news.
Yeah,
you
wanna
go
in the kitchen!
Okay.
Hi.
Guess what? I'll come over there. Everybody just loves the show so much that we got an order for 13. Expanded to a half-hour format with a further option, another 13. Jan has got us. She's so fantastic. We got a sure shot at syndication. Can you believe this? A half-hour show.
I'm really happy for you, Vincent.
Why are you eating this junk?
I have something to tell you. The Elon project went through.
Well, that's great. You should be happy. What's the matter?
I'm going to have to go down to Philadelphia.
Philadelphia?
They want me to run the whole show for them down there.
Philadelphia?
Maybe a week. This time.
This time?
It's an enormous project. Be happy for me
now. I know. Well, you deserve it, Cody. You do. It's not bad.
I'd have to eventually move down there.
You mean Ted wants you to move down there?
Well, not just Ted. This is my big break. The Zalon project is really big down there. There's all kinds of other clients who are really interested in...
Oh, so you are leaving.
I'm not leaving you.
Oh, so you are leaving.
I'm not leaving you. The logistics are complicated, but I was thinking that eventually maybe you could come down to Philadelphia.
I don't want to go to Philadelphia. I don't want a woman who's a plane right away. Oh, come on. Ted's so hot for you. He'd find another job if you wanted him to. If you'd ask him, he'd do anything you wanted.
That's mean. I've been working on this project for over a year, and you know it. You're making me choose. You said you'd never do that.
Just when things were starting to get off the ground, I don't believe
it. I thought you were different. What are we talking about here? Compromises? Someone has to compromise?
Yeah, it's not going to be you, is it?
And it isn't going to be you.
Cody?
Go away.
Look, I'm sorry. I want to talk to you. Come on.
We can't talk, please.
Is it redrawn?
Yeah, Pete's got it. Listen, the weather's just fabulous. We're going really fast, aren't we?
Very fortunate.
Great, over here. Is that going to put us really behind?
No, only a couple of days.
Well, that's not too bad.
We're building that fast track, and we're doing really well.
Oh, great. We'll have a site meeting tomorrow, okay?
Okay.
How do you do?
How are you?
You're doing great.
Good.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Hi. Hi. Very good work. Thank you.
Someday, if we're lucky.
So how are you doing?
Lonely, sad, love your job. You know all those things.
Have you heard from, dare I mention his name?
I can't avoid him. He's in the newspaper. He's on the idiot box. Something. I went out shopping the other day to buy some takeout sushi, and there his face was on the cover of it.
I know, I saw that box.
You saw that?
That was sushi.
You still love him, don't you?
Really, Molly. I'm glad that we did what we did, and even the way it ended. We didn't say we'd do anything that we couldn't.
Well, he was a great find. Did you know that he was the only American to have his restaurant listed in the world's finest?
It's funny. You never told me that. Vincent, he's such a goddamn paradox. You know, he doesn't need anybody.
Well, maybe you should have just tried, you know?
We both have other opportunities. We break our word. I can't take the pain.
God, I haven't heard the cynic in you in a long time.
Put me there.
People could not be happier. You're right on schedule. A little homesick, too, if I read you right.
I'll get over it. I miss Molly. I miss the office.
Hey, I didn't come down here to Philadelphia just to pat you on the back, you know. We're opening an office here, and I want you to head it up. How does Hutchkins, Dunlap, and Prescott sound to you?
What? You're offering me a partnership?
I've watched you grow into a mature, professional, amazingly wonderful architect whose work is making me very rich.
Do I have to think about this, or can I just say yes?
Just say yes.
Yes! 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 Oh, how's that for maturity? You know, you really are an incredible guy. Do you like it? I love it! I can't believe this is just a stack of drawings 6 months ago. Are we thrilled?
Just start taking their toll.
Hi, it's me. I'm sad. I'm lonely. I don't want to live alone anymore. I hate it here. Okay, I will cry. I'm trying not to. I'm coming home, Molly. I never should have left him. It was the wrong thing. Doing here?
You got a cold, don't you?
Yeah, for a change.
Going inside with your hair wet.
Walter! What are you doing here? Anyway.
I got something serious I want to talk to you about.
This?
Yeah? Proposition again.
Well, take off your coat.
It's late. There isn't much time. Come here. Okay, this is it, okay? Walter and I, we need a place to stay, and we thought if we could stay here one night, we'll leave tomorrow, we'll be gone, we'll be out of your hair. What do you say? I brought champagne.
What happened to your contract?
I didn't sign the contract. I didn't sign it. I thought, you know, why can't they syndicate the show here from an affiliate here? And so they're working on it. I think they'll go for it. What do you say? Can I stay?
I don't know.
What?
I don't know.
Oh, great. What do you mean?
Stay tonight. You stay forever.
Stay tuned for previews of more Shades of Love movies.